Forget about exoplanets, there could be exomoons with liquid oceans, and maybe even alien jellyfish. Hello, I'm Ian O'Neill, space producer for DiscoveryNews.com, and I'm commandeering the D News studio to talk a little bit about aliens, or more specifically, potential alien worlds that could support life. You may have heard all the kerfuffle about Kepler-186f. This Earth-sized exoplanet was discovered orbiting a red dwarf star within its habitable zone. This is exciting because if the exoplanet is rocky and if it has water, there's a good chance that its atmosphere could keep the water in a liquid state and possibly support life. This is the first Earth-sized exoplanet discovered inside the star's habitable zone. This is an awesome, awesome, awesome discovery. Kepler-186f was detected by NASA's Kepler Space Telescope, but it's not really a discovery of a second Earth. We simply do not know if this world is as barren and cold as Mars, or a broiling hellhole like Venus. Two worlds, by the way, that orbit within our Sun's habitable zone, but they are far from being habitable to life as we know it. So for me, there's another really cool possibility for potentially life-giving worlds out there in our galaxy, other than looking for habitable exoplanets, and it doesn't depend on how far away they are from their star. Remember the world of Pandora in the epic movie Avatar? Well, that wasn't an exoplanet, it was in fact a moon orbiting a massive exoplanet. And these moons are what astronomers call exomoons. Our solar system has some fascinating moons orbiting Jupiter and Saturn that may not look like the science fiction rainforest moon of Pandora, but they do have subsurface oceans beneath their frozen crusts. The water is heated to a liquid by tidal forces squeezing inside the moon, creating a heat source. There's no sunlight required. Take, for example, Jupiter's moon Europa. It has a subsurface ocean that some astrobiologists believe may be ripe for complex organisms to thrive. If you've seen the movie Europa Report, for example, you'll know what I mean. If you haven't seen it, I won't spoil the ending, I promise. Alien squids. Most recently, it was revealed that Saturn's moon Enceladus also has a subsurface ocean, just like Europa, and its tidal heating drives the dinky world's famous water plumes that you can see going out into space. So there could be some kind of cozy, life-giving environment there too. Earlier this month, astronomers made the first ever detection of a moon in orbit around an exoplanet, so this is an exomoon. They discovered it using the cool method of microlensing. That's when a planet or star passes in front of a distant star, briefly amplifying its starlight. Astronomers saw this little bump next to the light curve of the microlensing event, and they believe this bump is the first direct observation of a moon in orbit around an exoplanet. There's no word about whether or not this exomoon has any habitable qualities like Europa or Enceladus, but I can't help but wonder that maybe one of these frozen exomoons may actually have subsurface oceans containing life. I think it's time to launch some ice drills to Europa for, you know, research. Just don't take a swim. Does this get you excited for the next exomoon discovery? Tell us in the comments below and subscribe here for more D News.